Cardboard's a fantastically versatile material, and as you know, I'm a big fan. But have you ever wondered what the best laser settings are for cutting your cardboard? Well, I was kind of curious, so I put together a test of materials that I got at my local art supply store. What's the best speed and power and leaves the least amount of residue on the edges of your laser cut cardboard?
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
Alfred backpack hanger in stainless steel and aluminum, designed by me, holds your backpack, lets you charge your phone, holds your keys, super versatile. So I'm packing up some here that were recently sold. Thanks for those of you who've purchased recently. It really helps support the channel.
I've separated the materials into three weight classes. In the heavyweight class, ButterBoard, Chipboard, Mattboard, and Illustrationboard. These are all over 1 millimeter in thickness. In the middleweight class, all under 1 millimeter, Railroadboard, 4-ply Bristolboard, and STENCIL oil board. In the lightweight class, everything under a half a millimeter, we're using Yupo paper because I've never used it, and 300 series Bristolboard. If you're a light burn user and you use that software to power your laser, you can head to co2creative.co.nz and it will spit you out a power versus speed file that you can just open up in light burn and run on any material. I'm going to run this on all of the materials that we're going to do for this video. I'm looking for the cuts that have the smallest kerf, meaning the least amount of laser burn or the thinnest laser cut, and the ones that leave the cleanest cut, meaning the ones that leave the least amount of residue around my cut. As a general rule, I don't run my laser past 50% power. Thus, you see 10 to 50% power scale on the top of this scale. This is to increase the longevity of my laser tube. I've always wondered sort of what the optimum speed versus power is when you're cutting materials. And this test sort of verified my suspicion. You want to basically run at a lower power scale, just enough to cut your material so that you don't create a lot of smoke residue that then gets onto your material, at some sort of a reasonable speed so that you can accomplish this task. And it turns out that most of the power settings for the cardboard are pretty low, in the 20% to 25% power level, and also at not too crazy of a speed so that I can still get an accurate cut without having to worry about getting jagged little edges on my circle cuts. Generally in the 20 to 30 millimeters per second area, and all of these materials roughly fall into that. There's one exception, the illustration board, a little bit thicker material that turned out to look like it has a higher power and a little bit faster speed requirement. But the rest of them were all pretty low, which is really nice to sort of know. And that helped me put everything together in the test so that when we do some real world cutting, we have a good setting to cut all our materials. For reference, my laser is 50 watts, water cooled with air assist. And these are the settings for the real world tests that we're gonna do in this video in the heavyweight, middleweight, and lightweight class. First up is what's called ButterBoard. I know it as TaskBoard, and I've made COVID masks out of it in the past. Link up here on the right to that video. The next material is Chipboard, and this is something that I use all the time and I'm very familiar with, and I'm very comfortable using this material and I like it a lot. It's cheap and affordable. Next is a matte board. So it's white on one side and black on the other side. Pretty standard, it comes in lots of colors and it's also relatively affordable. Last is illustration board. This is by far the most expensive material, also the thickest, requires a little more speed and a little more power. In the middleweight class, we're gonna cut railroad board. This stuff comes in a bunch of different colors and is also readily available. 4-ply Bristol board, I love Bristol board, and this is just a thicker version, and I bought one sheet to do a test here. Here we have stencil or oil board. This is something new to me. I would sort of describe it as almost like a sheet of MDF, but paper. Last, we have the standard 300 series Bristol board. This is 100 pound paper basically, and I use it a lot. Last here, we got this Yupo paper, which I've never used before, and I would classify this more as a plastic than paper. I'm gonna build 2-inch or 50.8 millimeter cubes out of each of the materials. The way I do this is I build 4 of the sides with overlapping joints, so each side has one edge that's visible. And then I make the height of the cube 2 thicknesses of the material thinner than the material thicknesses, meaning I'm allowing for material thickness on the top and the bottom of each cube when I build it so that they come out square. I've made videos about cardboard basics and cardboard advanced basics, and so a link to those videos up here in the right if you're interested in learning about some basic cardboard model making skills that will cover how to make cubes and some more advanced shapes. I'm removing the blue painter's tape from each of the cubes now that they've dried. Be careful, this railroad board in particular is kind of tricky. It's pretty fibrous material and the tape really seems to go after it. Even the chipboard can be a little tricky as well. Just be careful, take your time so you can preserve the finish. Butterboard, or task board as I know it, just over a millimeter thick. It's off-white, and so I tend to not favor it, but it's a really nice material to work with, and the laser cuts it really beautiful. Gives you those nice sooty soft edges. Chipboard, probably the king for me because it's the cheapest, easiest material, and so readily available. However, it does really burn the edges because I think the material is so cheap. So if you can get past the dark edges, chipboard is for you. Mattboard, super bright white, which I really like, a little bit thicker than the chipboard, but it does leave some pretty dark edges. But it's nice, it has 2 color variations in one board, so it's nice and versatile. Now, illustration board. This probably leaves the darkest, sootiest edges on all of them. It's the most expensive material. It is super bright white, but I would not recommend it for model making. Railroad board. Turns out it comes in a whole bunch of colors. This is my first time using this material. I like it. It doesn't leave too many dark marks from the burn. Nice material. Wish it came thicker. 4-ply Bristol board, very nice material. A little bit on the pricey side, but it's nice, smooth, white material, and it makes for a really nice, clean model. The burns aren't too bad. Stencil or oil board, my first time using this. I like it. It's got some nice strength to it. Unfortunately, it comes in this sort of brown MDF kind of color. I wish it came in a different color. I don't like making models in dark material like this, but nice material. In the lightweight class, we have the standard Bristol board that I use a lot for lightweight paper mock-ups. Really nice on the laser cutter. Bright white, nice and smooth, a really good sort of cardstock general model making material. And Yupo, kind of the wild card here, is really more of a plastic. You can kind of see even the sort of melted plastic edges. It doesn't glue very well with white glue. Not optimal for this kind of a project.
Let me know in the comments below which of the materials that you like the best. Also, if you have some other materials that you've used that I didn't cover today, leave that in the comments below with your laser settings. Let me know how that works out. I'd love to try it. If you're a manufacturer of some sort of awesome paperboard modeling material, feel free to reach out. I would love to try out your material and perhaps do another video about something similar in the future.
Just as a reminder, if you haven't seen the Team C's hashtag from the other YouTubers, we're trying to raise $30 million to remove 30 million pounds of plastic from the world's oceans. Head on over to teamseas.org to make your donation. Link in the description below. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.